Hey guys, I'm here in Langkawi, which is a UNESCO protected site, and I'm doing a pretty difficult hike, as you might imagine, but it got me thinking. Got a guide over here. Hey, why don't you say hello?
Hi.
How you doing, man? Okay. Thank you. This hike would be infinitely more difficult without a guide. So what I was thinking is, in America, a lot of the people that first came there didn't know the terrain. They had trackers within a tribe, a group of human beings. It wasn't whoever had the most physical power or even intelligence that made it to the top that was most useful. It was the people that could put things in context, like the trackers. My friend over here, about 5 feet tall, maybe 55 kilograms. So he's able to do this a lot better than me. Apparently he smokes, so it's even more remarkable. I don't. So what's occurred to me about modern society is that since we've moved from books into digital media, the ability to emphasize outliers and make them primary factors rather than what they really are, which is exceptions, what that's required is a need for more guides and more trackers. And unfortunately, we're losing them. We used to call these people journalists, whistleblowers, things like that. Once you lose your guide, a 2-hour hike can lead to death. If you don't know where you're going, but you keep going, progress. But a good guide can make a 2-hour journey into maybe even 1 hour. Apparently this one's 2 to 3 hours one way. So we got to think about these issues and how digital media has made it easier to emphasize outliers, so that when my guide here tells me be afraid of leeches, I don't know what the percentage, I don't know what the stats are. Wear white socks, you can see the leeches. Got long pants. What are my percentages? Are the people who are doing these studies that say leeches are dangerous, or enough of a danger to be mentioned by the guide, are they surveying people with just shorts or long pants? We don't know. Most of us get the headlines. The guides are gone. All we have are sound bites. That's a big danger. That's why UNESCO and a lot of other, and World Heritage, when they get to these kinds of places, you know, they preserve it. They become the guides for nature, but we don't have any guides really anymore for a digital landscape. We tried by having, you know, people comment and so on, but you know, it's just like anything else. Digital is unrestrained. You can have a million likes on something easily, automatically. A book, you can print 10,000 copies and distribute it pretty easily, even 150 years ago, pamphlets and so on. But there's still a physical limitation because of the costs. A digital landscape reduces the costs of dissemination, thereby overwhelming all the other forms of media. So if I show you images of Indonesian Muslims, you're going to have a different viewpoint than if I show you images of other kinds of people. Suddenly, if this is all you see, because you don't travel, you start to associate women with headscarves, not with Catholic nuns, who also have headscarves, but with Indonesians, with a different religion. It all depends on what you see. And what's happened now, the ability to present information in context, this, you know, even as the information itself has increased exponentially, while the cost of dissemination to an even wider audience has decreased, you've got these twin engines of so-called progress that don't actually help you get anywhere because you don't have the guides anymore. And you don't have the guides because you haven't invested in them. Very few people have traveled extensively. I don't even know what that is. Looks interesting. Could be dangerous. Don't know. But I do know that without my guide, I'm lost. I'm making progress. Feels like it. But I'll be lost. You have to have the guides, ultimately, so you don't end up in a position where the outliers become the norm. And if you do that, you're going to get lost. And maybe you'll die alone, isolated, without any guides, many of whom have left to different pastures or different places where there is context. hopefully we recognize all that. Keep moving forward and try to find the guides, just like we did it back in the day when we had trackers, when we respected the trackers because we knew how valuable they were.